Hey, welcome back in to Eye on Agriculture. I'm Britton Rucker. We are in part three and a look back at the most important developments in agricultural law and tax from 2023. Once again, we're joined with Roger McEowen, professor of agricultural law and taxation at Washburn University, to walk us through some of these developments. Roger, we are starting out with something that's highly debated here in Kansas, commercial wind energy.
Yeah, Britton, this is number 10 on my list, and this was a big development late in 2023 when we had a federal court in Oklahoma that ordered the removal of an entire commercial wind farm, 84 turbines spread out over 8,400 acres. And the reason for that was back in 2017, this, by the way, this has been ongoing litigation since 2011, but back in 2017, the U.S. Court of Appeals for the 10th Circuit said the company needed to obtain a mining lease because they were mining minerals that they did not own in the process of developing that project. This is on tribal land in Oklahoma and the Osage Nation, and the Osage Nation owns all those minerals pursuant to a different federal law. Well, the company never obtained that lease, and so the federal court in late December of 2023 said, you have to pay attention to the courts, and now you're going to have to remove everything because you didn't have the required federal lease. And the estimates are this cost them about $300 million to tear it down.
Quite the hit. Also discussed this year, moving on, reporting foreign income, debated this year.
Yeah, this is an issue that has grown in importance for farms and ranches, particularly larger ones that have spread into other countries. There have been numerous farmers, and some in Kansas that I'm aware of, that have acquired farmland in Brazil and are farming soybeans or corn in Brazil. And of course, closer to us at home, you may have interests in Mexico or Canada. And so this is a big deal for farmers, particularly in the Dakotas that farm across the border. Well, we've got a rule that says that if you have a foreign bank account that at any time during the year has a balance of at least $10,000, exceeding $10,000, I should say, you have to file what's known as an FBAR form with the Financial Crimes Network, which is a branch of the Treasury, and report that. A case went all the way to the U.S. Supreme Court on this in 2023, and it was a penalty case because the IRS was asserting almost $3 million in penalties against a person that didn't file the report because he didn't know about the rule, and he had 272 foreign bank accounts. And the IRS was trying to say that the penalty is on a per account basis. His argument was it was on a per form basis. I have to file one form per year, and he didn't do so for 5 years. So he said it should be a $10,000 penalty times 5 years. So he wanted a $50,000 penalty. IRS wanted $2.72 million. Oh. And in a very close opinion, he wins 5-4 at the U.S. Supreme Court. The penalty is on a per account basis. So again, the lesson for our farmers and ranchers is if you have a foreign bank account, file the FBAR if that balance is over $10,000 at any point during the year.
An important lesson there. Well, Roger, thanks so much for coming on. We'll check back in with you over the next couple of weeks as you'll work through some of the biggest developments of last year in ag law and tax. Roger, thanks so much for coming on, and we'll see you next week. Everyone, stick around. Eye on Ag will be back after the break.